People who honk in traffic jams, what are you trying to achieve? I honk in Morse code telling everybody to chill. Dot dot dot, dash dot dot dash dot 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 dash. Greater than, dash dot dot dash. Translation, STFU, damn if I had gold to give. Edit, apparently I now have gold to give. I always think it's like geese. Geese just honk for honking's sake. Can confirm is here have geese in backyard all winter. Just shut up already, you're attracting the coyote. That my 1992 Chevy Blazer's horn is superior to all the other horns. Now that's some good vintage honk right there, boy. Because the fucking idiot in the F-150 keeps trying to merge into my car and won't quit texting. Edit. To everyone saying, just let them merge. I'm talking about people leaving their lane because they're too busy on their phone and aren't paying attention to the road. I'm not talking about people deliberately trying to change lanes. This is pretty much the only time I use my horn. I'm right here, dumbass. Stop trying to phase through my car. Quote, I honk in support of others' honkings. I honk at people who look like they aren't paying attention and are about to crash into me. I don't just honk cause I'm mad that I'm sitting there. This is the correct way to honk. Thank you. Back in Boo, Whitman called it a barbaric yop. They've taken everything else away from us. It's our one way to say to the world, I am here. Sometimes I toot when I'm driving home alone and nobody is around for a cheap thrill. Edit, grammar. In Italy, the honk is not only a fine musical instrument, but it also helps the flow of traffic. You see, when you stop in the middle of a tight one-way road to have a shot of espresso with Gianluca the police officer, who was just driving his service Vespa in the opposite sense, before he stopped to argue with the old lady on the fourth floor balcony. As you do, only so many people can just drive on the sidewalk to overtake you until one of the drivers meets his doctor and starts having a good, loud, passionate and unnecessarily elongated conversation about the physical state of the sister of the aunt of the grandchild of the third cousin of the best good friend of the driver, who from what I can hear, is quite excellent at playing the flute, and so the klaxon quickly becomes a great tool. First of all, to signal to the drivers behind to keep going straight and not merge into the road. Just like a beaver would whack his tail to alert the rest of his herd of imminent danger. But it also becomes great weaponry to deny the driver's ability to speak uninterrupted, since speaking with hands can only get you so far, contrary to common belief. Therefore forcing them to kiss each other goodbye and now turn around and drive to work. The car horn is truly the cherry on the cake of Italian traffic legislation. Edit, I'm Italian AMD, I love my country. In India, if you don't honk you will die. Apparently nobody looks at the road at all and instead uses echolocation, sonar to position themselves. It's music, it's art. The less you understand, the better it is. Edit. Well, thanks for the gold and silver. Sometimes I sit in my car at night and honk into the crisp air. Makes me feel complete. World peace. One horn at a time. Mostly just looking for another SUV to mate with. Preferably nice tires, low gas mileage. Starting a music band. You're going to be there for a while. Might as well make it entertaining. People rarely join me and get angry at me though. I'm now imagining a line of cars performing Bohemian Rhapsody. Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a traffic, ya monsieur. Live in NYC, work requires me to drive all over Manhattan, Queens, Brooklyn, Long Island, etc. 99% of the time there is a traffic jam. It is because an accident has already happened and everyone driving up to the accident slows down to get a good look. So, as I am nearing the accident, I honk in hopes of getting people to just drive normally past the scene. I never understood why people need to slow down and stare at the scene. This is the number one cause of traffic jams, slowdowns on the highways here. This a million times. Nothing boils my piss more than people slowing down to look at what's already happened. Rarely do people look to see that which is about to happen. Are you sure that they're slowing down just to look? Generally, you should slow down when you're passing an accident for safety. There is a massive difference between slowing down for safety and rubbernecking. You can safely pass at 30, 40, 50 miles per hour or more depending on the situation. 5 miles per hour though. You aren't being safe. You're being a nosy douche that won't see anything anyway, so hit the fucking gas. Greater than you can safely pass at 30, 40, 50 miles per hour or more depending on the situation. 5 miles per hour though. Says someone who's never responded to an accident on an interstate and almost been hit by self. Righteous assholes who think they can just blow by a scene with personnel on the ground attending to it. Does a flat tire on the side of a highway count? How about my car breaking down literally in the middle of a highway? Get real. Get space and go 50 and there's no problem, as your speed is not the concern. Proximity is. You know kinda how you go 50 miles per hour down the main street in your town while people walk on the sidewalk. Yet, for some reason that's not a problem. Weird. Let the person in front of me know how stupid they are for being on the road at the same time as me. Turds. Right? Who drives at rush hour? Nobody drives then, there's too much traffic. I think it's a regional, cultural thing. I never heard mass honking in the Western Canadian cities I've lived in. One time there was one solitary woman leaning on the horn in a Calgary traffic jam and you could see other drivers turning to stare at her with a "what the hell are you doing?" expression on their faces. Agree. Go to New Zealand, Australia, Scotland, Germany and people barely use their horns. Now I'm in Washington, D.C. These pricks will hit the horn for fucking anything. Making a legal turn whilst indicating? Get ready for some wanker in an oversized SUV to sit on their horn. But don't worry, the impatient prick will wildly go around you, cutting off someone else, causing more horns to be blasted. I went to DC on vacation with my family once. It was insane. Multiple people at every red light just laying on their horns. I don't honk in traffic jams, but I often wonder if doing so would create a cascade of honking that would carry to the front end. Get whatever jackass is causing the traffic jam to figure his shit out. I assume this is why people do it. Was behind the jackass causing a traffic jam, monsieur? He did move when I started honking. So yes, the chain does work. I'm just trying to move that big truck in the front. You can honk. It's your cake day. Happy honking and happy cake day. There's probably an anxious guy or two up ahead that has enough space to move forward and the horn will trigger his anxiety and he'll squish forward enough to let other cars move. Opposite of this, I hate when people squeeze as far ahead as possible on a hill and I have to gas it to not hit them. In the US where 99% of the people don't drive manual, removed, I honk to shame jackasses. Honk if you love ass. Toot toot. My dude. I sometimes honk as soon as the light turns green, then look over my shoulder to indicate the driver behind me did it. I bet you blame farts on dogs and babies. I'm just angry, so I make my car scream like I do. Mostly because I see people moving forward by about a dozen yards. Except the car in front of me. Because they're staring down at their cell phone. We could be idling 30 feet further along, but no. Many times traffic jams are because some fucking idiot won't move. Sometimes two cars involved in a fender bender will just stop, get out and talk while still in a lane. Accidents should be moved to the shoulder. If you are the idiot and you hear the roar of 1,000 horns, it might make you move out of fear. I joined the ranks because I am soldier in the traffic army fighting for the flow for everyone. Redditors who post extremely specific AskReddit threads that are mostly rhetorical. How much of a karma whore are you? I secretly hope my honk will cause others to honk, creating a chain reaction. Sort of an audible honk wave. Greater than honk wave, the next big genre of music. Years ago I visited NYC with my mom and the cab driver stopped behind another cab at a light and honked repeatedly, even though the light was red. My mom asked why he was honking and his reason was to remind the other drivers to go when it's green. Orgasm. Feeling a little horny. This guy honks it. Horngasm. People believe that a horn will miraculously clear the traffic. I always forget that I had to replace the rocket launcher with a horn. I do it for the Foley artists. How else will they get authentic street sounds for their movies? Ha ha ha, this one's creative. I am gonna steal this one for the future. It makes me feel like I have a little bit of power and control in an otherwise powerless and control-less situation. However, I've also heard that the sonic energy generated from honking one's horn can be harnessed to help the vehicles in front move quicker and more efficiently, thus assisting in the traffic flowing more effectively. The light is green. You are obviously unaware of it because you are off in La La Land. The light is going to be green for only so long and I'd rather not wait here for an extra 60 seconds because you aren't paying attention. The nice, quick honk is to alert you that the light is green. I'm sure you have places to be as well. Oh look, another passive-aggressive AskReddit question that accomplishes nothing, and is actually just somebody bitching in disguise. Right? Like, you know why, motherfucker? Traffic jams clear up one dickhead at a time. It's not volume, it's the dickhead in front of you playing with his phone or trying to creep into another lane instead of waiting for a gap. And the dickhead in front of them. And the one in front of them. And so on. People in general are garbage at judging and maintaining a consistent speed and follow distance, so they bunch up. Add to that the ones who don't pay attention and the ones who don't care and you've got a traffic. Yeah, monsieur. People also don't accelerate out of a jam and only get to their usual speed. Jams clear faster the more people get the fuck out of there once they're at the end of the snake. Please, I am just trying to find my son. His name is *honk*. Thank you for watching.